Welcome to the quickest quiz on radio. Today's contestants are Reggae Champagne and Justice Smith.
Audition for the Roadrunner movie. Yeah.
Meep.
I'm terrified.
Question one.
Tomorrow is the 1st of April, otherwise known as what?
5 seconds to answer.
Just for funsies, I'm going to run the clock down just in case I don't know. That's April Fool's Day.
Oh, right. Do you know what? Nice tactic. Cocky. I would have loved for the buzzer to have gone off. Got you. You answered April Fool's Day. I can tell you. Correct.
You know, I thought we might have been going meta. It wasn't even a real question.
No. Yeah. You know what I
mean? That would have been my defense if the buzzer had gone.
Nice. Justice, would you have got that? Would you have got that right? Yeah, okay, cool. All right, so no reason to panic.
Are the rest of them that easy?
Well, no. We'll see.
Well, actually, to be fair. Right, here we go.
Oh, gosh.
Question two.
Here we go, Justice. Today is National Eiffel Tower Day, whatever that means. But which city can you find the
this is
Eiffel
a morning show.
Oh.
4 seconds to answer.
Paris, France.
There we go.
That's right, right?
We can give you this.
Yay!
It's correct. Of course.
We were just there.
All right, next one. Justice is no stranger to movies based on famous games. But which Pokemon character did he star alongside back in 2019?
3 seconds to answer.
Depends if you consider Ryan Reynolds Pokemon, but otherwise it's Pikachu.
He's playing with us here.
He's playing with fire.
Like this.
He's playing with fire.
I don't like the cockiness.
You want us to Pikachu?
Correct!
Hey, Justice, gonna be honest with you, dude.
This one's hard.
I think it's harder, but I think you might smash it out the park.
Is it about Bridgerton?
No. Wait, how are those two things synonymous?
Someone hasn't watched Bridgerton. Slightly awkward.
All right, Justice, here we go. Dungeons & Dragons was first released as a game in what year?
2 seconds to answer.
1980.
50 years ago.
What?
You said 1980-something. It was incorrect. It was 1974.
Wow.
See, you accuse us of cockiness. That sassy little head.
Yeah, you got it wrong with it.
We got it wrong.
It's hard to become champion, guys. You can't just do it. All right? We will knock you down a few pegs.
Question five.
Spell Bridgerton in 1 second.
1 second to answer.
Bridgerton.
That felt good.
It was a loaded question.
I've got to be honest.
Set up, Your Honor. They planted it.
I've got to be honest. I'm giving you this still because that was impressive.
It was fast.
That was still impressive. The collector was still kind of going off.
Honestly, I think you pretty much got Buster and like Eminem who could have got that question. I don't know what you're expecting from me.
I didn't know Bridgerton had a D in it, so that's new information to me.
That's why they put me in the champion spot.
So that means, boys, you have scored 4 out of 5.
Very good score.
Well done. And the only
question... I let us down.
You didn't let us down. No one was getting that one. They set you up, fam.
Well, the only question you got wrong, funnily enough, is about the film you're actually here promoting. So, boys, I do have to say this. Do you two wake up, meet up, and just discuss how you both have the coolest names in history? Because it's like I've never interviewed.
No offense.
Like, I'm a big fan of a lot of people we interview, but normally it's like Ed Sheeran. Now, he's a talented guy.
Very cool.
But his name's Ed. Do you know what I mean? Reggae and Justice. It's next level.
Yeah, Ed's got that relatability factor. Do you know what I mean?
True.
Like, you're sitting at home, you're like, I could be Ed Sheeran. I sound like I'm Ed Sheeran. Do you know what I mean?
Mm. Yeah. But then you pick up a guitar and you're like, I'm definitely not Ed Sheeran.
Yeah, and I guess it might sound a little bit pretentious if you woke up and went, I'm Justice. It's like, you're not Batman, dude. Calm down a little bit. Reggae, in this movie, you're kind of, well, essentially, you're the knight in shining armor, right?
In this movie, I'm the guy who would wake up and say, I'm Justice.
Yeah, exactly.
If we were to sum up the character in one sentence, that's exactly what it is.
It's a lot to live
up to.
Do
you do that in the morning?
It's so much pressure having this name.
Yeah, when you're introducing yourself.
I feel like I have
yourself.
To have a strong moral code with this name.
Do you ever put a hand out and say, I'm Justice?
Yes, but not like that. Not with gravitas.
Sorry, that was a sidetrack. My character essentially is Justice. He's a literal knight in shining armor. He's got the armor, he's got the cape, he's got a sword, he slays dragons. He's that guy.
How different? Because obviously, we all know and love you from Bridgerton, right?
Mm.
Okay. So we're not going to say it's Is it Bridgerton plus dragons and orcs, or are you very different?
Very different. Very different. It's similar in that we're in a big escapist fantasy universe. It's very colourful. It's very fun. It's very kind of wish-fulfilling. Mm-hmm. But the wish-fulfillment is far more swords and capes and dragons and jokes and hanging out with Chris Pine and Michelle Rodriguez. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Makes sense.
That's a flex in itself, isn't it, really?
It's a bit of a flex.
I see someone on the internet described your role as a hybrid of Orlando Bloom and Legolas. So I'm not quite sure if they realise that Orlando Bloom plays Legolas. it's still quite the compliment. Right?
I'm planning to surf down an elephant in the sequel.
Nice.
That's where we're going.
And he shoots the deep arrows
cut,
as he does
deep
it.
Deep cut. There you go. He's watched the movie.
Now, this is a little bit niche as well. Bear with me on this. Here on the show, I'm quite into celebrity boxing matches, right? I think it's a good way to settle feuds, right?
And polish off a couple of celebrities.
You know what I'm trying to say? Who would you think would win in a fight between the Duke of Hastings and your character in D&D?
Zank, hands down.
Really?
So the thing about this character, so my character in D&D is called Zank Yenda. He's essentially a perfect knight in shining armor. He's like a commentary on the kind of hero you expect to find in this movie.
Okay.
So our director's favorite joke is that he's filming like the very serious dragon show next door, and then he accidentally wanders onto the D&D set that's full of idiots. And that's kind of the universe we're living in.
Are you feeling that right now? How you're feeling?
Nah, the levels are too high in here. Like the banter, like y'all could be in the movie. You could just walk right in.
Love that. So the movie's obviously, it's a comedy as well as being like action adventure. Oh yeah. Right. So
I'd say it's action adventure as well as being a comedy. Like it's a comedy first and foremost.
Okay,
you know
cool.
What I mean?
Okay.
And then
so,
like we.
How does your character relate to that? Because even in the trailer, you can see it. They're super, just like.
Down the line. No,
that's it.
It's weird. I'm kind of the straight man of this movie and absolutely not the straight man of this movie. Like being the perfect hero in a movie full of chaos, the idea is that I'm such a straight man that I become utterly ridiculous and everyone else is kind of looking at this going, how boring would it be to be perfect?
Yeah.
That's the kind of three line that we're in here. And so my job in this movie is I'm funny because the cast is funny.
Got ya.
So it's an ensemble movie. Like I said, you're playing with Chris Pine, Michelle Rodriguez, Jessica Smith, Sophia Lillis, Hugh freaking Grant. Mm-hmm. And so like all I got to do is set it up and then one of them knocks it out. I set up a joke, Chris Pine knocks it out. Done. I set up a joke, Michelle knocks it out. Do you know what I mean?
Love
so,
like,
my job
is great. How does that feel, Justice, for you? Like obviously you got like this little gang in the movie. If you are, you know, you look to your left and you have got Chris Pine, or you're looking at Michelle Rodriguez and you're like, we're about to go and fight Hugh Grant today. You're like, do you ever deep it like that? Because I'd be like, this isn't life.
Deepen it as a British colloquialism.
Yeah, what does that mean?
Oh, like you think about it. Like you think about
deep,
it. Like,
yeah. Do you know what I mean?
Yes and no. I think it's like when everyone's in the costumes, it's like the great equalizer. Mm-hmm. Like us all like doing silly voices and like, well, I'm doing a silly voice in the movie.
We should all be taking offense at that. All he's saying is he's doing a British accent.
Yeah,
it's a good British accent as well. We're all talking about it. It's very good.
Thanks, I appreciate that.
Love that.
Man was like just dropping like Dave bars on set constantly. That's where. That's how he learned.
That's the method. That is the method.
Titanium.
Well, look, it's an iconic game, Dungeons & Dragons, right? I mean, everyone knows the name. Even if you've never played, you just know of Dungeons & Dragons, right? Mm-hmm. Huge community as well. Since the movie, or even prepping for the movie, did you guys have to sort of like join the community? Did you play quite a lot? Because it's quite intense.
Yeah. We played as a cast before we started shooting, and that was a lot of fun because it was a real bonding moment. But also, I don't know if we played right because we just yelled over each other for an hour.
That sounds like every game that I've ever watched.
Okay.
The first thing we did, like the first thing we did before we shot anything, was a whole cast sat around a table, and it's a natural place for actors because it's basically just an improv game. You think of the wildest, magical, most goofy thing you can think of. Mm-hmm. Occasionally you try and be heroic, but that's no fun. And you pass that wild, magical idea to your right. On your right, Chris freaking Pine. He passes that to Michelle Rodriguez. Things get chaotic and a little bit crazy. And they're so sharp that we took that energy, rolled that into the movie, and that's what the movie's about. Like, the movie ain't about dragons. It ain't about magic. It ain't about swords. Like, that's all there. But it's about that feeling of when you get your mates together and just the wildest memories that will never be recreated again just kind of live between you. That's the feeling.
Sold.
We need to watch
Goosebumps.
We're going to watch. We're going to watch tonight.
Justice, if you want to keep your name, mate, you start saying you. Come on, man, because that was epic.
You can have it. We'll switch names.